Hello and welcome to GoTo Tech Reviews. Today we're going to be taking another look at gaming on the integrated graphics on the Intel Skylake processors. So if you recall from our previous video where we were testing the integrated graphics on the Intel Skylake processors, we were using the high-end Intel Core i7-6700K. Now some of you guys pointed out in the comments and requested that I test the lower end of the spectrum using the Intel Core i3-6100. This will more closely represent those who will be gaming on a tighter budget and do not have a dedicated graphics card. So this is what we wanted to look at. So one thing that I changed that's a little bit different on this go around is I am using a higher rated memory. I will be using G-Skill RipJaws 5, 8 gigabytes of DDR4 3000 megahertz. Now remember, the integrated graphics relies solely on the system memory at hand. And the faster that system memory is, the better performance we can expect. I will be using the same games that we did on the previous video, which are Minecraft, CSGO, and Awesome Knots. And from your guys' requests, I will also be looking at League of Legends and Dota 2. I'm not very good at those games. We're just going to be doing the training modes because I don't want to get into a live game online for 40 minutes and then quit halfway through and get ban hammered. But we're going to be using similar settings on the games that we have tested in the previous video, and that will give us a correlation. But that's not the main focus of this video. The main focus of this video is if you are on a low-end Intel Skylake processor and do not have a dedicated graphics card, can you game at 1080p at reasonable frame rates, and is it an enjoyable experience? So that's what we hope to find out, and let's just jump right into the gaming.
Thank you.
there you have it. Those are the results of gaming on the integrated graphics on the lower end Skylake processor, the Core i3-6100. I was really quite surprised at how capable it was gaming even at 1080p. As long as you are judicial and, you know, reasonable with your settings, you can pump out 30, 40, 50, sometimes even 60 and above. Now, granted, I wasn't doing this on the most demanding games and AAA titles up to this point, but that's okay. You know, we just wanted to do casual gaming and to see if the low-end Skylake processors could handle just casual gaming, and it does. So I'm pretty happy that, you know, my kids are going to be playing Minecraft on this machine down here. And by the way, this is the HTPC that I built, which I will be doing a build log of here shortly. I've already filmed it, but I decided to do this video beforehand because it was in high demand, because you guys requested it. So if you would like to see something in the future, just request it and let me know. And yeah, thanks for watching. This was a fun experiment to do and a fun video to do. I always enjoy gaming, especially in the name of science. So if you liked the video, please like it. Subscribe if you haven't to the channel already. We have new content every weekend. And to help support the channel and future content, click on the Amazon affiliate link, save it as your bookmark. It's free for you and easy if you already shop on Amazon, and it helps us bring you new content. Anyways, thanks for joining us today, and I look forward to giving you another video next week. So thanks for watching, and we'll catch you then.